teachers of Reddit. Who are the students you remember from 5, 10, 20 years ago and what did they do to be remembered? No longer a teacher. By 5 years ago I was teaching freshman English and this kid just was not doing any work. I didn't want to fail him and tried to meet with him and figure out what was going on. I suspected home issues. He kept saying he had a lot going on and that he would do the work, he was just distracted. Finally contact the mom because he is not doing anything and I'm worried he is going to fail. She emails me this long email that basically said her kid was a crafty butthole who could sell ice to an Eskimo and not to trust anything he says. In the same paragraph proceeded to tell me, well, he did become a father in the fall so he has had his hands full with that. WTF lady. I was more concerned about the blasé way she talked about her 14-year-old reproducing. Yeah, he dealt with a lot. Probably still is. I honestly can remember all of my students, but the ones that pop up in my head from time to time are the ones I had an especially positive weird interaction with. One, the student who told me she was a lesbian and wouldn't stop giving me hints that she wanted to hang out with me after school or during the summer. Two, the mentally impaired student who would make casual death threats to anybody for any random reason. Example, oh, that would be a shame if the next exam is hard and we would find you beaten in the parking lot. 20 years ago there was a little girl in my class who was rather plump, clean, never spoke and didn't have many friends. I'm only saying this to describe the sort of kid she was. One day she was slow to pack away and it was just me and her in the classroom. I had a big bag of sweets and asked her if she'd like one. She very nervously said yes and I said she could only have one if she stopped and talked to me while we had them. We had a lovely chat about her dog and her family and I picked her book off my shelf I thought she'd like to read. Every week after that she'd hang back. We'd share some sweets or whatever either of us had in our lunchbox and we'd talk about things. After a few months of this she said, I hope you don't mind giving up your break, and I said to her, I look forward to it. The class is so big we don't get time to talk and I haven't got a daughter so this is lovely. When the year ended she had another teacher but she'd still pop in and say hello, less and less often as she made friends and grew in confidence. 6 months ago I bumped into her while out shopping. I gave her a big hug. She said she remembers being very lonely at 11 but talking to me gave her something to look forward to. She went to university and was now a primary school teacher, and she always keeps sweets in her desk. This and the bloke with the beard driving the number 11 bus who wound down his window and shouted hello Miss Div, I'm still reading. I was a volunteer English teacher in a prison. I taught the college prep courses, basics of essay format, composition and evidence-based writing. One of my guys was blatantly bipolar, and his writing was brilliant, but he kept failing, just couldn't hold it together through the term. Had something like a decade left on a 30-year sentence. A few years later, I'm walking to work and bam, there he is working with the street cleanup team. Sure enough, he'd been diagnosed bipolar, was on stable meds, holding a job and going to school. TLDR. Dude sort of spent 22 years in prison for having an untreated mental illness. Once inpatient mental health facilities were phased out, prisons have taken their place and we wonder why there's such overcrowding in so many places. 5 years ago, a senior that was the barely getting by usually failing didn't give a crap kid, talked back, total butt that was going into the Marines like his dad and certainly wasn't interested in web design but had to take a tech course. I could eventually tell he was just trying to be a bad butt for the girl next to him that was a complete bad girl. So I separated them at the end of first 6 weeks and I somehow got him interested. He became one of the best in the class. I have no idea how I did it but something clicked. They eventually did a group project making a website for a business idea from one of my other classes. Not only did he lead the team and make an awesome site, but he helped the team from the other class with their business idea. Finished my class with an A. He said his first A since elementary school. I was so dang proud. I knew he would never use the ability to do web design in the Marines, but maybe it showed him he could succeed. I now live to do that for another kid. I teach third grade. When I give spelling tests, I tell the kids they can doodle on the back in between words. A super bright, creative girl used to write me Star Wars quizzes on the back of her tests instead. But now, some of the more curious kids sometimes write questions that I'd answer. But these quizzes were on another level entirely. Who did Han shoot in the Mos Eisley Cantina and what is Leia's home planet are a couple examples. She then include cute little doodles of the characters involved in the questions. As a huge Star Wars fan myself, possibly not as big a fan as this student though, I will never ever forget these amazing quizzes and their amazing creator. This is wonderful. In 8th grade I got in trouble for writing out musical notation on the back of unrelated quizzes. I will always remember two students I had 10 years ago. A girl and a boy. They were senior year of high school and about to graduate. They were dating and she was pregnant with his baby. I had a great relationship with them both and I had hopes they would make excellent parents. She went into labor in the middle of my class and he had to rush her out. They came to my wedding last year with their 9-year-old child. If you got pregnant at my high school, they transferred you to the alternative school across town. No, I've never been given a plane ticket. When I was newly qualified, I had a huge class of 36 pupils. I had one boy who was returning from the local pupil referral unit for behavior support. He had been through a really rough childhood and had awful attachment disorder issues. I remember on the first day I met him, we had to evacuate the room because he was trashing it. I spent a lot of time working with him. When he started with me, he could barely write his name. By the end of the year, he was writing stories. It took a lot of work, but he trusted me so was willing to try. He was a lovely kid. That was nearly 10 years ago now. He'd be 18 now. Excellent. Thank you for your support. I hope he had more teachers like you as he grew up. About 7 years ago, when I was a mainstream first grade teacher, I had a little girl I wished I could take home. She was being raised by her grandmother, who was about 75 and also raising several of the girl's cousins. Her mother was in the throes of addiction, and the grandmother, while doing her best, was clearly overwhelmed and in way over her head. She was provided the basics, roof over her head, fed, and appropriately clothed, but when she first started school she was like a little wildling. She was so unsocialized, and no one had taught her anything academic. She didn't know letters, numbers, shapes, or how to write her own name, and she was starving for affection. I loved her so much, because she was so eager and so sweet, even if she would quickly put any kids who got in her way on the ground. I lost track of her after she moved on to middle school, but last I heard, she wasn't doing well, very angry and out of control. And I don't know if her grandmother is still even alive, so who knows who she lives with now. If she had ended up in different circumstances, she had so much to offer. Breaks my heart. I knew a girl like that in my school. She just seemed angry at the world. Talk to her 10 years after high school. Complete turnaround. I hope the same happened to your girl. My first year teaching 5 years ago, I taught 6th grade, which is still in the elementary school in my district. I'll never forget Caden. I used a classroom money system where kids earned money for doing jobs, making good choices, etc. They could pay out for sitting on the couch I had in the classroom or for auctions at the end of the quarter, etc. We were walking back in from the school spelling bee, and I hear Caden say to her classmate, "How could Garrett misspell paprika? I had a lot of money riding on him winning." Turns out they had a black market going with my classroom cash. They'd gamble during indoor recess, bring in snacks to sell at lunch and, apparently, made bets on the school spelling bee. As much as I thought it was hilarious, I had to have the obligatory "you're 12 years old and can't gamble with our classroom money" talk. It was a year full of stuff like that with this kid. Always entertaining. And his dad was hot. He was known amongst teachers as Hot Dad. Memorable year. Good kid. Ha, of course. There's also the girl who, when I moved the 4th grade the next year, wrote out how to kill as part of a creative writing assignment. That one was graphic. Or the girl who wrote out a list of white girls who are B followed by "I have one word for Ms. Always the moon." B, those were fun. Caden's class gambling ring sounds like a Saved by the Bell plot. During my teaching internship, there was one kid who was very bright, performed at the top of the class, but was clearly stoned half the time. He was one of a very few disadvantaged minority kids in a very affluent white school district. One day, he adjusts his hoodie and a joint falls out onto the floor at my feet. He sees it, I see it, and nobody else does. I looked him in the eye and gave him a you dumb ass look as I stepped on the joint to hide it and then said something to direct everybody's eyes to the board so he could pick it up and I could pretend I never saw it. I didn't sign up to be a drug sniffing dog, and wasn't going to be the first positive role model to turn this kid over to law enforcement for punishment that could screw him over for life. That was the day I decided I had to teach in an alternative education environment. Not being sold out by an authority figure probably meant a lot more to him than any lesson he'd have learned by getting in trouble. And I bet he remembers it too. I remember the ones who are on my Facebook, and I love seeing how their lives have progressed. Sadly, I also remember the ones who were lost. I remember Jamie, who was shot to death in the alley behind his home. He was 16. I went to his funeral and it was so hard to see his parents. I had only been teaching a few years at that point and it was the first student I lost. I also remember the twin sisters I had in my classes. The day after spring break, their counselor came and told me that their father had committed a murder-suicide and just like that, they lost both parents. I went to that funeral as well. The mom was being mourned. The dad was not mentioned at all. They moved away to live with an aunt after that and I always wonder what happened to them. There are others I remember for other reasons. One because she went on to have a successful career. Another is working on a new treatment for childhood cancer. And one couple got married a little over a year ago. They met in my class. The girl had a very jealous and large boyfriend with anger management issues. Her classmate was a rather small and quiet guy, very nice. I could tell they were getting closer and closer and I was scared to death that the boyfriend would find out and my classroom would be the stage for a murderous rage. Eventually, the girl BF broke up and she started dating the tiny guy. They have now been married for a little over a year. No idea what happened to the large, angry guy. Not a teacher, but a student of one. When I was in high school, I suggested to the teacher that if a student can get a 90 or better on a test, they can be excused the absence of one homework. She had a policy of every time you missed a homework assignment, you got a point off your final grade. Fast forward a decade, I was visiting my parents and they asked me to pick her something from the supermarket. I ran into her in the aisle. She came, said hi Rob 132. I just want to tell you that I've kept your policy in place of a 90 or higher on a test to make up for a missed homework. And every year I tell the students about it and I always mentioned your name. It really helped some kids study more to make up on missed homeworks. The worst part is I never got to use it. I only got in the mid 80s. Math wasn't my thing. Did tutoring in college as a part-time job. There was a kid in high school at risk of failing his algebra class and almost failed his previous math class. As you can tell, his parents were desperate. Turns out no one really sat with him and tried to get him to really understand or begin to figure it where his knowledge gap was. I tutored him for maybe 3 months and literally went back to the basics and made sure there was nothing he took on faith. If he didn't get it, I didn't let him get away with it. My strategy was to have him explain everything and talk while he was solving the problem. He went from an F student to a B, which he couldn't get any higher simply due to limited number of tests throughout the class. His parent were so grateful they actually gave me a $300 gift card to Starbucks. They knew I loved coffee. It funded my coffee spending for a long time. Not a teacher, but I was, and still am, earning my pocket money in my middle school by being a math tutor. I once had a student who could perfectly tell and was at almost any math problem, but she couldn't show how she got there. She just knew, but her teacher, despite correct answers, always was giving her F for no thoughts process. 2 years, 2 H a week teaching how to write her thoughts. Good times. Now she is on math physics class and she don't need my help, but we are still in contact. I was like that in elementary, middle, and early high school. Some of my maths teachers caught on I was bored. They set me to tutoring the other kids who were struggling. Tutoring the other kids showed me how to show my own work because I'd had to slow down long enough to think through what was happening quickly in my head so I could explain it to the kids who didn't get it. Not a teacher, but I'll tell you about a time a teacher actually remembered me 18 plus years later. So I was selling shoes at Macy's at the time when I was in college and this little old lady approached me asking for a size. I went back to get it for her and saw her sitting next to a couple of older women her age. I took them to her and let her know if she needed anything else to please let me know. Why, thank you, disoriented possum. That's very nice of you. You have grown up a lot, said the woman next to her. I remember thinking, how the frick does she know my name, because I wasn't wearing my name tag that day. I looked at her and studied her face and it snapped. Mrs. B, I asked. Yes, she replied. I knew it was you when I first saw you. You look and sound much like your mother. It was Mrs. B, my pre-kindergarten teacher's assistant. I thanked her for the compliment and later checked out her friend. Gave her a hug and bid her farewell. It was a very touching moment for me. I wish I had asked her what it was about me that she remembered my name and who I was. I guess I'll never know. Nearly 15 years ago, I worked in an absolutely horrific department. One morning, before school started, I had the pleasure of being told how crap a teacher I was by my head of department. I'm not. Needless to say, I was cut up, and spent most of the morning crying on and off. Just before I was due to teach my year 11s, three of the girls found me crying. One of them stayed with me, one of them blocked the doorway to refuse entry to anyone else, and one of them ran off to the loo to get me a tissue. These were the hard nuts of the school, the ones that were dumped on me because their year 10 teacher couldn't handle them. I will never ever forget the kindness they showed me on that day. I wonder where they are now. Well, now this is powerful. My GF's first year of teaching, and she taught nonverbal severely autistic kids. She worked really hard with these 4, 7 and 8 years, through their meltdowns and seizures. One parent's evening, she was showing the parents some of their art, and they pointed at the child's NAMD and asked who wrote it. She said the child did, and they started crying, saying they did not think the kid would ever achieve something this simple. It was a good day. I cried when my son, he's ASD adult, wrote his name for the first time. He has the most amazing teaching assistant with him in school, and worst thing, I regularly tell her she amazing and his progress is down to her. He has another tier for the first 2 months of school and no progress at all. 15 years ago, had an 8th grader pull a sub sandwich out of his jeans pocket in the middle of class and started eating it. No wrapper, just shoved in there with shredded lettuce going everywhere. I couldn't help but laugh. His dedication was commendable. At first was confused how this was possible, then realized you said his and remembered boys actually have pockets that work. My first teaching assignment was as a 7th grade history teacher. That's where I met Brianna, and then I punched her in the temple. It wasn't intentional. She came into class late while I was facing the board and lecturing. No idea she was there. I spun around and pointed at the map in the back of the room. Bam. Brianna goes down. I caught her right in the temple. I apologized and helped her up. She was dazed but knew it wasn't intentional. So she rubs her temple and says, I'm going to tell my mom on you. We both chuckle and I go on with the lesson. The next day she comes in and says, I told my mom you punched me. I ask, well, what did she say? Brianna says, she said I probably deserved it. She and I and the whole class laugh. And that would have been a good enough story, except 5 years ago my wife was teaching at a high school and this little girl comes in and asks if she's related to Mr. Spodson. My wife says yes and Brianna tells her the story. They both laugh, and while Brianna never has my wife as a teacher, they are both besties the entire time she is there. Then about 3 years ago, we are at the mall and bump into Brianna with a friend. Before we can say hello, she's excitedly telling her friend about the teacher who punched her in the head. When she gets to the punching part, she actually punches her friend in the head. Poor girl staggers 2 steps and starts laughing her butt off. That punch has gotten a lot of mileage. To this day I tell my students not to mess with me, because I'm the only teacher they know who has assaulted a student and gotten away with it. That was 15 years ago. I had a student named Victor, and this was a 7th grade English class in a high poverty and very diverse environment. 65% were English language learners. I had this vintage Arkansas Razorback statue that my parents let me have. It was a ceramic statue that was really cool and laid on my desk. Victor was up and he knocked it off my desk. He showed no remorse for it, and when I told him usually when people damage or break things that aren't theirs, they say I'm sorry, he just stood there in silence and had no empathy for what just happened. I'm pretty sure he's a serial killer now. My best guess. I had a student stand up in the middle of class and mimic what he would do if he was a Nazi surrounded by Jews. The last I heard, he ended up in jail for animal cruelty and domestic violence. Sounds like something a serial killer would have in their backstory. I taught preschool for 5 years and then switched to upper elementary, 4th and 5th grade. My first 2 years teaching upper elementary, I looped with my class. I had mostly the same students for 2 full school years. They were like my own children at that point. They are getting close to graduating high school at this point and I think about them all the time. I can still list first and last names of every student and most of their parents. They were my favorite group of students in my 12 years in education. I think they taught me just as much as I taught them. You should try to go and watch their graduation. Taught primary school in the UK. I'm an American teacher. In 1988, Louise was 10 years old. The class was on a swimming field trip to the city pool. She got her first period while swimming that day. She was the first girl in her class to start menstruating. Apparently, when she climbed out of the pool, it was obvious what was going on. All of the kids noticed and started teasing her. She was quite embarrassed and I was embarrassed for her. I took her to the changing room to clean up and change into her school uniform. I got her a tampon from a lifeguard. It was quite awkward. This didn't happen to me personally, but I know a woman who teaches 7th grade science. Her last name is Chestnut. She made the huge mistake of disclosing to her students that all but one of her children had died in a house fire years ago. And as soon as she got done saying this, some butthole started singing Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire. She threw her glasses, then broke a clipboard over her knee while screaming bloody murder. Everyone in the class got lunch detention. I'm equally horrified and thinking that kid was incredibly quick-witted. Obligatory. Not a teacher, but I'm an outdoor education practitioner. Only worked in the industry 5 years, but this one counts, I think. From my first ever outdoor job 5 years ago, I was assigned by the company to handle oversee the same residential primary school group for a week. All 7-8 years old and from a really deprived area. There was one little girl who had real issues. Only half a heart and a hole in the half she did have. But she was the most engaged with the program and probably the most engaged kid I've ever worked with. In 1 week of outdoor activity, she went from being a really shy, crying kid to being super outgoing and enthusiastic. She also developed a really good relationship with me and my colleague and would come searching for us at 7 a.m. sharp every day to eat breakfast with us and say good morning. Unfortunately, she's probably no longer with us as her condition was terminal and fairly short life expectancy, but she made me realize I really enjoy seeing the effect outdoor education has on the personal development of kids. A surprisingly sharp contrast to my other personal life goals, which were to serve in our nation's most elite infantry combat unit and one day go on to special forces. Unfortunately, that dream is on the back burner now after circumstances out of my control forced me out of the later stages of training twice. So for the next 3-4 years, my priority is an outdoor education before I decide whether to give the military one more shot. And I'd say that little girl played a huge part in the decision for me. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.